Hi, so it's about 10 o'clock at night and it's all quiet and calm in my house, and this is when I've got my dressing gown on. I've got my Nigella Lawson kind of moments going on, and I like head into my kitchen and into my fridge, and I don't even really know what I'm looking for. I just maybe feeling a bit flat, a bit kind of needing some sort of pick me up or whatever. I've been eating healthy all day and I'm like looking for something, and I might start with a sort of reasonably healthy snack, like I have some yogurt, and then I eventually just give up and have the chocolate or the cake or whatever that I knew I shouldn't in the first place. I don't know how many of you relate to that, heading into the kitchen looking for something. But one of the things that I've done, which I got from a Priscilla Shira book called Fervent, is that I've kind of got my prayer strategy up on the walls, on the cupboard in my kitchen, because I spend so much time in the kitchen. I'm in and out of here all day long, and there's some really good reminders. So I just thought I'd show you some of the verses that I've got in my kitchen that give me encouragement throughout the day. So I just flip the camera around so you can see. So one of the things she talks about is focus, to see what's really going on behind the scenes in your life. So I've got some verses there and some of the quotes from the book. About asking God to increase my passion for Him, that my heart would be for Him. Some verses to help me with that. And then the kind of family that I want to have, and the things I want to be praying over my family and speaking over them. And let your speech always be with grace, as though seasoned with salt, so that you will know how you should respond to each person. I mean, that's definitely words of wisdom to cling to. Some of the arguments that go on around the dinner table in my house, hurts about the kind of way God can take the burden of our pain and help us forgive 70 times 7. I've got some verses here on identity. We are His workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand so that we would walk in them. So it's just encouragement to remember who I am, who I belong to. Pressure is a big one for me. There's always so much going on in my life. So it's really good to have that reminder there. And God doesn't live in the past, not to kind of think about those things. So alongside all my pictures that my children create, I've got these verses on the wall, and I'm going to keep updating them, thinking about the different areas that I want to work on, or what I feel God's kind of challenging me, areas to grow in. I do think the idea of putting up Bible verses around your house is a really good idea, because whenever you see them, it kind of prompts you to read that verse, to think about that verse, to maybe pray. And our day-to-day lives are so busy, we can easily kind of forget things. So I do think that's a good idea. And I do also think that when people come into your home and they see those things, it can often start a conversation. So quite a few people have asked me about this, because obviously mine's kind of got taken over my whole kitchen now. But it's been really positive, the kind of comments I've had from people and the conversations that we get from that. So just encourage you to do that, maybe kind of, because at the end of the day, when you've got that feeling and you're looking in the fridge, it's not really going to satisfy you. But putting up some of these verses and just, looking to God, that will satisfy you when you kind of look into His word and get His peace.